Just K, let it play, boy.
It's your girl Trap C. We have another episode of Ramen Drive. Today we have
One Take MacGyver in the motherfucking building in the car.
Alright, so just go ahead and tell the people your social media handles where they can look you up at.
One Take _ MacGyver. Everything MacGyver, MacGyver, One Take spelled out.
Alright, and y'all already know how it go. We play a beat for the artist. If the shit fire, they stay in the car. If the shit trash, they get kicked out. So, you know, let's hope for the best today. You ready?
Yeah.
Alright.
You got me a little nervous.
You should be.
Let's get it. I'm on rhyme and drive, cause I got this drive. I mean, this a freestyle, but you still gon' ride. Line for line, I'm the best you can sniff. These rhymes is rhyme and sniff. Doing all this crime's a bitch, I mean. Yo, if you talking record, don't ask me. I'm a rapper, and got a rap sheet. I'm usually with handcuffs in the backseat. Yo, hey, been a man in the South since I moved here. I'm just focused on the new years. Why y'all niggas dwelling on the old years? You can't live here. I'm One Take, yeah, the take for one. Niggas don't want the take when the take just come. Nigga, I'm that nigga, riding in the car. I'ma tell you how I'm going this far. This a freestyle, off the top of the dome. I'm in the dome like I'm in N.O. It's no, yeah, you wanna kick me out, I'ma kick you. Yeah, I'm spitting these bullets, One Take is a missile. Yeah, nigga, kiss the flow like I'm under the mistletoe. This ain't Christmas, you might miss this, no dismiss. I'ma tell you how I'm with this wicked, wicked. Yeah, cash rules everything around me. Like cream, niggas don't play, I'm rolling between. I fuck your bitch, I'm making a cream, I make a scream. This ain't the movie, niggas don't do me. I'm rolling with the Uzi, rolling with the Pumi. Nigga, don't move me, nigga, don't lose me. This a freestyle, so you can't move me. You can't choose me, I'm so choosing. I'm so chosen, I'm so rosen. I'm DeRozan, like I used to play for the motherfucking Bulls. Whatever he played for, I'm so high, I don't even know. I can't even flow, cause my words fucked up and my words mussed up. Yeah, my nigga Kate in the front seat. Got my girl Sid in the back seat. You don't even wanna ask me. I pack heat and I'm high as fuck off that heat. Okay. Seems like I stayed in the car.
I mean, you kept going. You ain't giving me a chance to talk. I don't like that. But I will say, on the beat, you was good, but when they stopped the beat, you kind of was going real downhill real fast.
I was just in a certain zone. You know how you get in that zone. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. How did you get into the whole music business? How did you get into rap?
Rapping started. I mean, I don't know. I've always been rapping, you know, battling different forms of rap. You know, it's just always been something I can do, you know, ever since I've been young. I've been, you know, putting words together, trying to make them rhyme, you know what I'm saying, doing different things with music. It's just always been a part of me.
So how long have you been rapping?
Like, recording, I've been recording for about, taking it serious for about 6 or 7 years.
Okay.
You know, so in my mind, that's a long time. I'm just trying to make more stuff happen.
So what places have you performed at so far in your rap career?
I performed at Mooney's. I performed at Brooklyn Lounge, Onyx. I performed at it's a number of places. I mean, once you perform a lot, you know, I perform at Mooney's every Monday. Make sure y'all check that out. Podcast Adversary. No Adversary, they doing good, man. They putting people on for the city. You know what I'm saying? I'm just trying to be a part of that. Shout out to Reese Raps. She's somebody that's doing good in the city as well. You know, she putting on for the city, so I'm just trying to be a part of that as well. You know what I'm saying? I see a lot of people trying to put on, so I'm just trying to be a part of that since I've been rapping. See, the thing, like, I get migraines or whatever, so it's like, it's been hard for me to really, you know, get out there the way I want to, because, you know, having headaches or whatever. But
I'm getting control of it, so I'm just doing my thing now.
Do you have any works out currently, or like can people go on like iTunes or YouTube?
I got therapy. I got therapy out right now. Okay. You know what I'm saying? This one of my hats. This my clothing line right here. I do different sayings. You know, the whole thing is therapy. So y'all can definitely check that out. It's about 14 tracks. Nothing but fire. You know what I'm saying? Something real lyrical. If y'all want to hear lyrics, you know, y'all check that out. It's on all platforms. Okay. Everywhere that you listen to music, you know, I put it out there. So make sure y'all check that out.
So what are your goals for 2020 as far as like being an artist and, you know, in the music industry?
I mean, my goals, I mean, if I can get like, you know, like I say about 50 people a day, you know what I'm saying? That's putting my standards real low. But you know what I'm saying? If I can at least get 50 people a day to hear what I'm talking about, you know, that'd be a big plus for me as far as music goes. And you know, my other goals besides music is my clothing. You know, I definitely want to get my clothing off the ground. Definitely want to get everybody to see what I'm doing with the therapy brand.
So do you have like a place where people can go and do your clothing? I know that's kind of off subject, but it is a part of you. It is a part of your brand.
Right. I appreciate you asking that. So it's onetakemacgyver.com. It's my website as well. So definitely check that out. Onetakemacgyver.com. It has all my clothes on there. If y'all like what y'all see, go ahead and cop anything. You know what I'm saying? Anything from female clothes to baby clothes to clothes for dudes. You know, all kind of stuff. You know, so check that out as well. And I got another project dropping. It's about to be called the Libra Tape. Shout out to everybody born in October, all the Libras. You know what I'm saying? But the Libra Tape is going to be my next EP. It's not going to have as many tracks because every track I want to be fire. I'm probably not going to have like no beats on there at all. You know, but...
Oh, so it's going to be more
of
that?
Nah, it's going to be all beats. It's not going to be like acapella at all. It's going to be like all beats. It's going to be all fire, all hits.
You scared me there for a second, baby.
Nah. It's gonna be like all hits, so you know, once that drop, I'm putting on for all the Libras, you know what I'm saying, letting them know what we about Libra Tape. Good. I don't really know the start date, the drop date of that yet, but
it better be during Libra season.
Yeah, most definitely, but I'm gonna let y'all know.
If you can work with anybody in the game, whether it be a producer, an artist, young, old, dead, alive, who would it be and why?
I would work with Pat Poose. Pat Poose has always been my favorite artist. You know, he's somebody that I feel like is real lyrical. And when I first started, you know, he's somebody that really got me started rapping. So definitely Pat Poose is somebody that I want to do a feature with. If I do a feature, you know what I'm saying? I don't really do features, but, you know, Pat Poose hit me up.
Why don't you do features?
I don't like features on my...
Are you afraid somebody might like...
No, I don't do features on my song because I can do everything, so I don't feel like I don't really be checking for people to beat on my music. Because when I do the music, you know, it's already complete as one whole song. So like, I get on somebody else's song, but I don't really reach out and ask for features on my music because, you know, I'm creating the whole thing. So that's really why I don't do features on my music. But you know, I definitely... I let somebody on their track.
So what y'all think, Ramen Drive? Should I kick them out? Hey, you didn't know it's no advisory. I feel some type of way about that. Especially because you said you perform training day every Monday. You know the people, you know as you come out. A, okay. B, you did really, really good on the beat. But you completely lost me when you went acapella, like completely like that. You could have just did without that. You could have just let your 16 be your 16. But you went the whole 32. And in the end, I'm sorry. It kind of hurt you more than it helped you. I know you. I know your music. I see you every Monday doing your thing. But I'm going to have to kick you out on this one, dog. So, driver, if you could pull over, we're just going to go ahead and let him out. Let him find his own way back to his car. And that's gonna be the end of Ramen Drive. Bang.
RSK, let it play, boy.